Tech Cox, delivering happiness at South by Southwest. Super excited to be joined by the co-founder and CEO of Foursquare. Hey. Have you checked in here yet? That's the question. Dennis Crowley.
I was going to on the bus, but I decided I was going to take a nap instead.
Okay. So anyway, Dennis Crowley is co-founder and CEO of Foursquare. Can you tell us a little bit about Foursquare and what you do today?
Yeah, sure. So Foursquare, you know, we're about 50 people. We're based out of New York. We're trying to build things for mobile phones that make cities easier to use and the world more interesting to explore. So we've got a whole bunch of people, about 7.5 million users now, all around the world. They're checking into places, their favorite cafes and bars and restaurants and coffee shops, sharing the things that they love to do and the things that they're really, you know, excited about finding with their friends. And, you know, just trying to find ways to connect people with the world and connect merchants with some of their best customers. I'm passionate about, like, what the next generation of mobile phones and mobile technology looks like. Like, you know, you walk around here and everywhere you go, people are on their phones all the time. And I don't think that's what we're supposed to be doing. Like, the phones are sensors. They should be talking to networks. They should be doing work for us and, like, letting us know about interesting things. Like, we shouldn't be, you know, in front of our phones all the time, like, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So I look at a lot of the stuff that's coming out and just see if we can find interesting opportunities to, like, take advantage of, you know, field communication, passive GPS, like, you know, phones with better location. There's a lot of interesting stuff coming out. But there's always a little bit of additional functionality every year that's squeezed into some app, right? With the Foursquare stuff, like, we have our, you know, this trending server that shows, here's what everyone's doing, all the places you can see as trends, as places move up and down, and, like, it helps you figure out which party to go to, what panel to go to, right? A lot of the other stuff that's going on is, like, big group messaging services, like, how do you coordinate groups of people, and, you know, like, doing it outside of Twitter, outside of check-ins, you know, doing this messaging stuff. We've been using Groupon as a team, and it's been working out fantastic. And that stuff's just really interesting. I think the stuff that's most successful here is the stuff that, you know, it helps groups of people coordinate a little bit better when they're on the ground in Austin, and people are most likely to take those tools and bring them back to Seattle and Boston and LA and San Francisco and then spread them to their friends. I'm pretty hooked on the Twitter these days. You know, I was kind of slow getting into it, but I use that as a means for everything. Like, I've got enough followers now that you can just ask a question to Twitter, you get an answer to everything. Like, we do customer support for Foursquare over Twitter. I try to reach out to fellow entrepreneurs, to, you know, to kids that go to my high school and kids that went to Syracuse that are looking for inspiration. This guy's rocking a Foursquare t-shirt right now. What's up, dude? How are you? So yeah, it's kind of that's the thing that's I've been hooked on. It's part of my day now. When it goes down, it's like the end of the world for me. I mean, people say all the time, like, oh, you guys are so successful, Foursquare is so successful. Like, I actually look at a lot of the stuff as, like, a string full of failures, like, one after the other. You know, I've been trying to do this stuff for a while. We did Dodgeball, it didn't work out. We brought it to Google, it didn't work the way we wanted to. You know, I was working at startups before that were trying this and weren't able to make it work. And, you know, I think we've learned from all of those lessons. Like, we figured out, like, what works and what kind of makes these products feel special and feel magical, and we've baked that into what we're doing now. And, like, we're getting a little bit better at it. So, I mean, I think we're chock full of advice, but, you know, my mom has some of the best stuff. It's like, you know, she would tell me when I was younger, like, do the stuff that you love and the rest will follow, which doesn't make any sense at the time when you're, like, in high school or even, like, your first job out of school. But, you know, we've been trying to solve the same problems for, like, 10 years. And, you know, there's something to that. We keep going back. We keep trying to fix them. Like, we love what we're doing, and, like, things are starting to happen. You know, I've had people tell me my whole career that, like, the things that we're most excited about are just, they're dumb ideas. They're never going to work. No one wants to do this stuff. And, you know, people say that about Foursquare now. People are saying about Foursquare and Dodgeball years ago. And at some point, you just got to ignore that stuff and just, you know, find a way to prove to yourself that the things that you're most passionate about either work or they don't. And then you learn from that, move on, or just continue what you're doing. This has been an interesting South by Southwest for us. Like, we came down here with the mission of, like, telling a different story about the company. Like, for 2 years, people were like, oh, it's a game built on check-ins. It's kind of, like, fun and cute and whatever. But no, it's like we're doing real, real hardcore computer science. Like, people are giving us a lot of information about the stuff they do every day. Like, you know, we get 3 check-ins a day from the average user. And now we recycle all that data. We give it back to people. And, like, we basically made, like, a recommendation engine for the real world. Like, Amazon does it for books and Netflix does it for movies. And we can do it for, like, hot dogs and hamburgers and pinball machines and chicken parm. Like, it's awesome, you know? And that's like a... No one's done that stuff before, and it's an exciting moment for us to come down here and get to talk about it. The most interesting stuff is what, you know, people are building now that, like, the mashups that people are building now between different social services. You take a little bit of Twitter, you take a little bit of GroupMe, you take a little bit of Foursquare, like, you kind of mash it all up and you see what comes out of it. And I mean, people are building crazy stuff off our API that like we don't have the time to build, we never imagined building, and that stuff's awesome because it's the stuff that changes the way like you experience the way you walk down the street. And like that's the stuff that really gets us excited. And you know, like, we're building it, they're building it, like people are finding ways to build it in with Twitter and to Foursquare. I mean, it's all starting to happen.